Hello everyone, my name is Alisa. I will be sharing about morphology and linguistics. And before that, I want to thank you for the audience who are willing to pay attention for my presentation. Let's start. My background of this study is about morphology, because morphology is one of several sciences in linguistics that study the eyes and see and the outs of words and the function of this thing in front, both in grammatical function. What is morphology? Morphology is the study of language itself, such study the formation of word or morpheme, and also variation of combination of words or morpheme in a language. From this example, we can make about distinction between two type of morphology. The first is free morpheme, and second is about bound morpheme. Free morpheme, that is morpheme that can stand by alone, stand by themselves. Free morphemes have several basic types, namely verb, nouns, adjective, preposition, and others. The example is study is verb, man is noun, kind is adjective, on is preposition. Free morphemes are divided into two types. The first is lexical and the second is functional. The first is lexical morpheme. Are morphemes that can stand by alone and can convey the content of the message we convey, divided in three, that is name, that is verb, nouns, and adjective. The example is read is verb, baby is noun, and cool is adjective. The second is functional morphemes. Are morphemes that can stand alone, but the content that will be conveyed is unclear and divided into four, that is conjunction, preposition, article, and pronouns. The example is but is conjunction, at is preposition, the is article, and she is pronoun. And second is bound morpheme. Bound morphemes are morphemes that cannot stand alone but must be attached to other morphemes. Bound morphemes are divided into types, that is derivational morpheme and inflectional morpheme. Derivational morpheme, these bound morphemes are used to create new word or create word from different grammatical categories than the root word. For the example, adding the derivative morpheme nas, change the adjective to good for the noun of kindness. The second is inflectional morpheme, are used to show if a word is plural or singular, if it is past tense or not, and if it is a comparative or possessive. So the conclusion of my presentation about morphology is the study of the words, how they are formed, and their relationship to other words in the same language. Its analysis, word structures, and word parts as a stem, root, prefix, and suffix. I think that's enough for my presentation. I apologize if there are mistakes in my presentation. Thanks for the audience and have a good day.